I'm often asked for tips on the basics of good video shooting, and I always answer, if you want to shoot better video, learn how to use one of these. And I don't mean a film camera, but I mean learn the basics of manual control and the fundamentals of capturing an image. And you'll be able to shoot better videos no matter what kind of camera you're using, but especially with a DSLR. So to help you guys out, I'm gonna have a short series going over some of the basics. And the first one, we're gonna talk about aperture, which refers to the opening of the iris inside the lens, as you can see here. Aperture is measured in the focal ratio, which is the ratio of the opening of the aperture to the opening of the lens. So in other words, a f2.8 aperture means that the aperture opening is 2.8 times smaller than the overall opening of the lens. This affects your final image two main ways. The first being exposure or brightness. You can see as I close down the aperture, the image gets darker, and as I open it back up, the image gets brighter. The second major way aperture affects your image is in depth of field. The larger the aperture, the more shallow or narrow the depth of field or focus area is. In this image, I'm shooting at f2.8, and you can see the front iPod is in focus while the back iPod is blurred. Now, if I stop down the aperture or bring that F number up higher, you'll see that the back iPod is in focus, but because it's letting in less light, I had to compensate by increasing my ISO. Let's take a look at that concept a little more in depth so you guys can really understand it. What you see here is a very basic diagram of how a camera captures an in-focus image. Like I mentioned, this is very basic, so more advanced lenses would have a lot more stuff going on, but I think this will get the point across. So in this case, the far iPod is in focus. The light from it, represented by the red dashed line, passes through the lens, is refracted, then goes through the iris opening of the aperture, which those two yellow lines represent, then comes to a point at our film or our sensor, which is that gray line. So the next iPod, the closer one, with its light represented by the blue dashed line, is taking the same path. However, notice the point of it on the far end meets past our sensor. Now in this case, that close iPod would not be in focus because it would only be in focus at that point. And since our sensor isn't there, it's going to be blurred. But what would happen if we closed our aperture, bringing those two yellow lines together? You can see it smushes the triangles, so much so that the light from our close iPod, the blue dashed line, appears to come so close together at our sensor that it's making a point, and in that way the whole image would appear to be in focus. And that is how closing the aperture gives you a deep depth of field. So those are the basics of aperture. In the coming weeks I'll have videos covering ISO, shutter speed, and frames per second. As always, feel free to leave any questions or comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.